say that it's unusual is a gross understatement. As you go along, you develop knowledge. For example, I thought if you'd asked me a year ago, I would say the only people that would handle cadavers would be medical schools, mortuary schools, only to find out that there's vast numbers of people that use cadavers. For example, OSHA, United States military, on and on and on. So that the potential sources where it could have been maybe removed or stolen are vast, a lot more vast than I would have answered you a year ago. We're at the year anniversary of his discovery in a semi-remote area of Economy Borough. It's obviously a woman over 50 years of age.
We found when we got to the morgue that her eyes were missing and they were red rubber balls in their place. Well, there were eye caps in there, which is a common prosthetic used by funeral directors and embalmers. We checked with eye donors to see, with that as well, and we weren't able to get any information that way either. We've gotten into quite a few different areas of law enforcement throughout the country. We've had help from the FBI, from the state police. We've had help from NASA, just looking for help with the entire case. And we've reached out to so many different people that have been so helpful with us, I think, since it's been such a bizarre thing.
This case has compelled people. I've heard over and over again, that's somebody's mother, that's somebody's aunt, that's somebody's friend, and I think that was a big motivator. So everybody's come together, so to speak, to try to see if we can resolve the question of who this person is. All the resources that have been made available to us, it didn't cost us a dime. Obviously, we've been more successful proving who it isn't rather than proving who it is.
Well, people have been very responsive. The leads that we have gotten were all from in that first couple of months, and we were able to investigate all of those, and some of that included contacting family members, getting dental records, and just some information from the family helped us exclude some as well. Dr. Beal, who is an odontologist, has a complete set of her dental record, and we do have to have a dental record to be able to compare that too. We've also looked at DNA, which has been disrupted by the embalming process. We're trying another avenue of DNA now, hopefully that'll work for us, to help be put into NamUs and CODIS so that it can be compared to everybody else that's in that database. We're also looking at an isotope test. This isotope test should be able to tell us by analyzing their hair and the teeth samples as to a general idea or region of where she may have been for the last 6 months to a year, and then we can focus that particular area with her pictures and photographs, to attempt an identification. We should have an idea of where she came from. All we know for sure is that she showed up here.
I got a call from the coroner up in Erie County, who's Lyle Cook. He said, I think they're looking for you down in Beaver County. And he said, call this guy. And I called the police chief down here, and he immediately had me on this, and I promised a 24-hour turnaround for a drawing as soon as I had access to the head, that was. And I produced a drawing rather quickly for them, and they also wanted a 3D reconstruction, which is what the sculpture is. I just got a phone call fairly recently from Chief O'Brien saying that there had been other cases where some good results had been had when they did a combination of certain scientific tests with age regression as well, because obviously some people might know you from 20 years ago. I have to say she was a slightly trickier case than others because it's sometimes easier with somebody who has very idiosyncratic features, ears that stick out or a prominent nose or anything. She's very sort of neutral looking, right? So that made her a little tricky, at all, but then also to age regress her. So it took a little longer than I expected, and I finally got it, and I think it's good. I think we're solid now. So I took her back to a few decades, to her 30s. And of course, there is another long hair with glasses option that is floating out there as well. So options are key because then you can also see how different people can look just with a change of hairstyle, with glasses, without them. But also you can see what's similar, and you can start to perhaps float a memory of, your Aunt Sally or whatever in this lineup, and it sort of works. I feel I have an attachment to this one that I really want to see it resolved. Oh, I just really want to know her name. It's something to, have somebody else, to look her right in the face, to hold her head in your hands and to say, you know, I really hope that we're able to resolve this for you, you know, find out what happened. She does have a lot of people, she has a lot of good people working on her case, and so a resolution, I think it'll be found. There's just a lot of sort of monkey wrenches thrown into this one, so to speak.
She's on my mind 24 hours a day. There's nobody deserves to be found that way, and she needs to be identified so she can have her name put to her face and we can move forward from there.